Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. This is your science lecture of grade 4 and I am your science teacher Aparna Pandey from Arjun Progressive School, Lamachon. So student, as you all know that we have started our revision and in revision we have started chapter number 8 and its name is Animal Reproduction. In this chapter we have already done one part of this video where we have discussed about the reproduction and where we have discussed that how many types of reproduction and what are the animals that show that type of reproduction and some other thing, right? Like the structure of egg and many other things. So now students, in today's video we are going to study further. Means already we have done studies, now today we are going to revise further some important topics. So let's start. You can see that I have written here some important points, so we are going to discuss about them. So you can see chapter number 8, animal reproduction, and this is revision video. Now first what I have written here, incubation. Incubation means, incubation is not a new word for now. All of you, you all know about this, that incubation means habit of birds to keep their egg warm by sitting on them. Incubation means the habit of birds to keep their eggs warm. And how they keep their egg warm? By sitting on them. So this habit of birds by which they keep their egg warm by sitting on them is called the incubation. Next one is hatching. What it is? H-A-T-C-H-I-N-G, hatching. Hatching means when the baby comes out from egg. So what we will say, egg breaks and baby bird comes out. Hatching means egg breaks and baby bird comes out. It is called hatching. Now you all know that many times we say life cycle of butterfly, life cycle of cockroach, life cycle of hen, and so many things. So what do you mean by this word life cycle? So life cycle means the stages. What it means? The stages of development from an embryo to an adult. What do you mean by life cycle? The different stages from which that baby animal get changes into the adult one. The different stages, including from changing baby to adult, is called life cycle. Again, you can see life cycle, the stages of development from an embryo to an adult. From an embryo, even not baby, from an embryo. Embryo means developing baby. Well, it is not turned into a baby, but the stage of developing baby, right? So life cycle means the stages of development from an embryo to an adult is called life cycle. Next one is what I have written, butterfly. Now we know that butterfly has different stages. So how many stages butterfly have and what are they? That we will revise, right? But how many stages butterfly has? Butterfly has 4 stages. How many stages butterfly has? Butterfly has 4 stages. And what are these? Name them. So what are these? Egg, then caterpillar, then pupa, then butterfly. What are these stages? Egg, then caterpillar, then pupa, then butterfly. So what we have learned, these all things thoroughly I have explained you in the topic when we have discussed this chapter. So if you have any confusion, you can go through that video for revising this complete topic. Here we are doing quick revision. So in butterfly cases, when we are saying egg, so we say a very small egg, and then from these eggs give birth to caterpillars. These egg gives birth to caterpillar. Then caterpillar after some time get changes into the pupa egg. Then pupa turns out into butterfly. So this we have already discussed, right? Now next you can see here one word, cocoon. What it is? Cocoon. Now what is this cocoon? See students, you have to remember that cocoon is a word related to butterfly only, but this word does not comes under the stages of life cycle of butterfly. Cocoon is a word related to butterfly only, but this word we do not include this word in life cycle of butterfly. When we talks about the life cycle of butterfly, we have only four stages, and these are egg, caterpillar, pupa and butterfly. Now, as you all know that we have discussed about this word cocoon in case of butterfly only, but you have to remember that this word is not included with the life cycle. Then what does it mean? Cocoon means the spinning of silk thread in a form of pen by larva. Means the larva. Achha, what is the larva stage of butterfly? Caterpillar is the larva stage of butterfly. Okay, first remember this, that what is the larva stage of butterfly? So caterpillar is the larva stage of butterfly. Now when we say cocoon, then what we are saying? The spinning of silk thread. Cocoon means, but we are saying the spinning of silk thread in a form of pen. In a form of pen means जो by larva means जो हमारा larva है, and what is the larva of butterfly? Caterpillar. तो caterpillar क्या करता है? Caterpillar spinning करता है, बुन देता है हमारा किसको? Silk के thread को. और कैसे बुनता है? In a form of a pad, एक pad की तरह अपने लिए पूरा एक अच्छे से गद्देदार pad बना लेता है उस silk thread का. तो that is the stage, that silk thread pad, that is called cocoon, which is spinned by the larva of butterfly. So what do we say? What is cocoon? The spinning of silk thread in a form of pen by larva. Then next come here, this is cockroach. What it is? Cockroach. So about cockroach, we know that how many stages cockroach has? Cockroach has three stages in its life cycle. Cockroach has three stages in its life cycle. What are these? Egg, nymph, cockroach. What are these? Egg, nymph, cockroach. First stage of life cycle is egg. Then second stage is nymph. And third stage is cockroach. Okay? Now, when we talk about the life cycle of cockroach, then what do we say? Here is egg and this is nymph, this is cockroach. This nymph, what is the nymph? Nymph is a what? Nymph is a second stage of cockroach, and this cockroach is a adult cockroach, and this nymph we can say young cockroach. Okay? Another thing is that you have also, you know that we one more word related when we talk about the life cycle of cockroaches, we come to know about one more word, that is molting. M-O-U-L-T-I-N-G, molting. So what do you mean by molting? Molting means shedding of skin. Molting means shedding of skin. And when this molting occurs? When the time when nymph get changes into the cockroach. The time when nymph get changes into the cockroach, between this nymph and cockroach one stage occurs, that is molting. When molting occurs, after that nymph get changes into cockroach. Nymph get changes into cockroach. Okay. Another thing is that you can see here, next one is frog. What it is? Frog. Now, how many stages are there in the life cycle of frog? When we talk about the frog, then in frog's life cycle, there are four stages. Then in frog's life cycle, there are four stages. And what are these? Egg, tadpole, young frog, and then frog. What are these stages? Egg, tadpole, young frog, and then frog. So, if we talk about the larva stage of frog, then which one it will be the larva stage of frog? This tadpole. Tadpole is the larva of frog. And after this larva stage, tadpole gets changes into young frog, and then young frog gets changes into the adult frog. So students, here we have discussed some important points. What are these? Incubation. Incubation means sitting by the bird on egg for warming their egg. Hatching means when the baby comes out from her egg. Life cycle means the different stages of changing from embryo to the adult. Then butterfly, it has four stages. These are egg, caterpillar, pupa and butterfly. Cocoon is the pad that is spinned by the larva. From the silk thread. Then next we have cockroach. Cockroach has three stages, and these three stages are egg, nymph, and cocoon. And here we also discuss about the molting. Molting means the stage when skin shades out. That is called molting. Then there is frog. We know about frog. We have four stages in frog. These are egg, tadpole, ear frog, and frog. So this we have discussed now. Let's discuss something more. The part which is left, all the things that we have covered. See, you know about the fish. If we talk about the fish, so fish breathes from the gills. Okay, and they lay hundreds of eggs in one time. When we talk about the fish, what is the difference between the fish and the frog? That fish is a fish, but frog comes under the category of the amphibians because frog lives on land as well as in water. And the difference between fish and frog is that fish breathes only through the gills, but frog breathes with the help of the gills as well as with the lungs. And not only with the gills, when we say about the young frog, then we can say that they breathe through the feathery gills. And when we talk about the adult frog, they breathe through the moist skin. And when they are on land, they breathe through the lungs. Okay. Then reptiles. About reptiles, you all know that they, like lizard, they give their eggs on ground only. Okay. Then lizard, crocodile, alligator, snake, turtle, these all are the reptiles, and their hard, brittle eggs in same place on the ground. Okay, they give their egg on the ground only. And how these eggs become swarm? They get the sunlight, through the help of the sunlight. Then we had discussed that animals that give birth to babies. So what are the animals we call them, those who give birth to babies? The animals that give birth to babies, or we can say the well-developed young ones, they are called mammals. They are called mammals. And when we talk about the fishes like whale and dolphin, they also come under the category of the mammals. The baby develops here. What some specific things are there about the mammals? That the baby develops inside the womb of the mother. Like in other animals and insects, so those who lay egg, what they used to do? They lay egg outside and then their baby is developing there. But in the case of mammals, baby develops inside the womb of the mother. Now, and the mother feeds the baby with her own milk and protects it until it learns to look after it. Mammals में क्या होता है बेटा? जो mammals के babies होते हैं, वो अपनी mother के ही milk को feed करते हैं. Mother के ही milk उनका food होता है, और उनकी mother उन्हें कब तक देखती है? जब तक, मतलब mother हो चाहे parents हो, वो तब तक उनको look after करते हैं, जब तक वो खुद इस कंडीशन में ना आ जाए कि अपनी केयर कर सके. तो दिस इज द कैटेगरी ऑफ द मैमल्स. वी कैन दिस इज स्पेशली क्वालिटी ऑफ द मैमल्स, नॉट कैटेगरी. सो बेबीज ग्रो बिग स्ट्रांग एंड हेल्दी विद द मदर्स मिल्क. एंड वी ऑल नो दैट ह्यूमन बींग्स मीन्स वी ऑल ऑल्सो कम्स अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ मैमल्स. देन see, there are three important features of reproduction in mammals, though I have discussed, but I am reading here again that most mammals give birth to fully formed young ones. As I told you, they feed their young ones with their own milk and they look after their young ones until they are old enough to look after themselves. There are some mammals like the spinnerator and the duck-billed platypus which lay eggs instead of giving birth to babies, and these are the exceptions. What do you mean by exception? When we talk about the whole class, देखो बेटा, जब हम कहते हैं ये exception है means जब हम पूरी क्लास किसी पूरी एक ग्रुप के बारे में बात कर रहे होते हैं, उनके बाकी फीचर्स सेम होते हैं लेकिन कुछ एक दो चीज़ें अलग हो जाती हैं, तो वो दोनों कैटेगरी में आ जाते हैं, तो देन वी से दैट दिस इज एक्सेप्शन. जैसे वी आर सेइंग डग विल प्लेटिपस, ये क्या है, दिस इज मैमल ओनली एंड दिस गिव दिस कम्स अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ द मैमल्स ओनली बट इट ले एग. तो ये क्या हो गया, एक्सेप्शन हो गया. मैमल क्यों है, बिकॉज इसके जो बेबी होंगे वो इसके मिल्क पे ही फीड होंगे. लेकिन ये देन वाई वी आर सेइंग कि दिस इज एक्सेप्शन, बिकॉज मैमल्स गिव बर्थ टू यंग वंस एंड देयर बेबी डेवलप्स इनसाइड द वूम, लेकिन ये क्या करता है, ये एग देता है. तो दैट्स वाई वी आर सेइंग दैट दिस इज एक्सेप्शन. Now we have discussed what is reproduction, the process by which living thing produces its own kind. Molting means shedding of the skin. Nymph, young one of cockroach, and albumen, you know, like the thick jelly-like liquid surrounding the egg yolk. Metamorphosis means many changes that a young one undergoes before becoming an adult. So students, today here we have discussed the, means we have revised the whole chapter. One more part we have discussed earlier, and this is the second part of chapter number 8, and here revision of chapter number 8 is complete now. So please go through these revision videos. These revision videos will help you in doing quick revision, and if you have much doubt in any topic, then you can go through the prior videos which we have done the complete videos of the chapters if you have doubted any topic. So I hope that this video will help you in revising things. Thank you, and have a nice day ahead.